Today, I'm going to tell the story of the national hero of Indonesia, the Raden Ajit Kartini. Kartini was born in a noble family on April 21st, 1879, in Jepara, Indonesia. Kartini's mother, Nasila, worked as a teacher, while her father, Sister Ningra, worked for Dutch government. Her parents felt so blessed when Kartini was born. My wife, look at our daughter. She is so beautiful and adorable. That's true, my husband. I hope when she grows up, she will be a smart and brave woman who is helpful and useful for other people.
Definitely, she'll be an amazing woman.
In the past, Indonesian women had very low social status. They did not have the same rights as men obtained. They did not attend school to get education. Since Kartini was born in a noble family, at the age of 6, Kartini had the opportunity to go to Dutch school. But when she was 12 years old, she had to live inside the house and be kept in a seclusion. Her father did not allow her to go to school anymore. Kartini was very sad, so she tried to talk to her father. Excuse me, Father, may I ask you something?
Yes, my dear. What would you like to ask?
Father, can you please tell me why I can't go back to school anymore?
My dear, you are now 12 years old. Girls at your age have to live inside the house and be kept in seclusion.
But, Father, I want to study and play with my friends at school. I miss my teachers, too.
I'm sorry, Kartini, but you must obey our customs and traditions.
During her seclusion, Kartini continued to educate herself on her own. She wrote letters to Dutch protesting the gender equality of Japanese tradition. She fought against the discrimination towards women. At the age of 24, Kartini married the Regent of Rembrandt, after getting married, Kartini planned to start her own school. Then she asked permission to her husband. My husband, in my opinion, both boy and girl deserve the same education and social life standard. Would you please allow me to build a school for girls?
Okay, my wife, I agree with your opinion.